In the last 24, 48 hours, there have been quite a few stories that have not gotten a ton of coverage in the mainstream media. As former White House Press Secretary Ari Fleischer said, bias is often found in stories the press does not cover. And last week, we found out that Democrat Congressman Eric Swalwell was infiltrated by an alleged Chinese spy. The spy cozied up to Swalwell, raised funds for his 2014 campaign, and even planted an intern in his office. And that relationship continued until the FBI briefed him in 2015. And that was some very good reporting done by Axios. But after entangling with this spy for years, Swalwell hypocritically went on to be one of the lead instigators of the Russia collusion hoax in the impeachment sham. Swalwell wrote this on his congressional webpage: President Trump and his team are directly and indirectly tied to Russia. That was not true. He then said in September of 2020, the president has a compromised relationship with Russia. Untrue. April of 2019, he said President Trump certainly acts on Russia's behalf and acts like Russia's leader. Not true. January 2019, Eric Swalwell said it's pretty clear President Donald Trump is an agent of Russia. Not true. And Swalwell shamelessly claimed Donald Trump Jr. and Jared Kushner had an eagerness and a willingness to work with the Russians during the 2016 election. Again, it was false. In 2019, he falsely claimed this yet again when inquired about collusion by a reporter. And these baseless attacks were false, yet covered breathlessly by the media. There was no coverage, however, of Swalwell being the one implicated with not Russia, but China. In fact, the New York Times website, as of this morning, had not one result for Eric Swalwell's ties to Chinese spies. Not one result. And when the Swalwell story broke, guess how many minutes of coverage it got on ABC, NBC, MSNBC, and CBS? Zero. CNN devoted 3 minutes and 16 seconds to it. However, it was covered on Fox. Interesting pre-election and post-election coverage, too, on the Hunter Biden scandal, which was not covered at all by many outlets in the lead-up to the election. In fact, on October 15th, you had a New York Times headline that said, Trump said to be warned that he was being given Russian disinformation over Hunter Biden. Now, December 10th, just a few months later, New York Times headline, investigation of Hunter Biden is likely to hang over Biden as he takes office. Washington Post on October 16th, the headline read, the truth behind the Hunter Biden non-scandal. Now you have the Washington Post headline that says this, Hunter Biden tax probe examining Chinese business deals. Politico, October 19th, Hunter Biden's story is Russian disinformation. That's a favorite. Dozens of former intel officials say, false yet again. December 2nd, now Politico reads, Justice Department's interest in Hunter Biden covered more than taxes. Really interesting turn of events, and good for those who covered what was a story all along and not Russia disinformation.